We've been talking about outrageous prices at the supermarket checkout for some time now. Today, the government agreed to better protections for suppliers, but what will it mean for the rest of us?
With great power comes a responsibility to do the right thing by consumers.
No, he's not talking about the amazing Spider-Man. He's talking about reining in the distinctly unamazing supermarket duopoly, ripping off both customers and...
For too long, we've seen supermarket chains take advantage of suppliers.
The government today accepting 11 recommendations from a report aimed at protecting farmers who supply the big supermarkets.
We're thrilled not just with the content of the report, but also the government coming out immediately and accepting all of those recommendations, holus bolus.
The main changes?
Making the Food and Grocery Code mandatory.
That code, formerly voluntary and toothless, will force the grocery giants to act in good faith towards suppliers, policing unreasonable demands and threats from supermarkets. Via the second big change.
Dramatically increasing the penalties on supermarkets if they do the wrong thing.
Supermarkets facing fines of up to 10% of their annual turnover, a figure that could reach into the billions. The third big change?
Providing some avenues for farmers to make complaints without the fear of retribution that they have had up until now.
Suppliers set to benefit from a confidential complaint mechanism to the consumer watchdog that reduces the risk factor.
You're not going to make a complaint against the big supermarket if you think you're going to lose the contract.
In statements, Coles and Woolies have both welcomed the move, saying they were consulted extensively.
If the supermarkets behave properly, they shouldn't be too worried about this.
So while the changes might mean a
fair go for farmers,
what do they mean for you and me at the checkout?
It's really good for shoppers at the supermarkets because they get lower prices and higher quality.
I'm not sure it will be enough to get prices down.
The code of conduct will improve things for suppliers. It will do nothing to bring down the cost of food and groceries in Australia.
This is about not just fairness for farmers, but fairness for the consumers that they ultimately supply.
Economist Greg Jericho has been keeping a close eye on what the supermarkets are up to. So, Greg, what do you think about this idea? Does a better deal for farmers necessarily mean that consumers pay more?
Hi, Wally. No, not necessarily, but I think the suggestions that this new code of conduct and all the fines that are with it are going to lower prices for consumers is probably a bit overblown. I don't think this is really going to have a big impact on prices because, as your report noted, one of the problems with the supermarkets having such a hold over the entire market is it's two-faced. One is it's the prices that they're able to offer us, but it's also what they're able to get from their suppliers. And this code of conduct is really about the suppliers rather than the consumers.
So, Greg, I see the politicians out there saying, oh, well, it's going to be cheaper for consumers, you're going to get lower prices in supermarkets. But how's this stuff actually going to be policed? And I always get a bit suspicious when the two big supermarkets who are the target of this inquiry rush to say, yeah, it's great.
Yeah, I mean, that is always a bit of a worry. I mean, the one really good thing I think about this announcement today is giving the ACCC, they're going to set up a mechanism to allow anonymous, in a sense, whistleblowing protections and mechanisms so that suppliers, farmers can actually contact the ACCC and not fear that retribution from the supermarkets. Because in the past, it kind of has always got back to the supermarkets who has done it, and you've, you know, been able to be shut out or, you know, your product is not favoured as much and it really can hurt you that way. So I think that aspect is really good, for suppliers. But as you say, is it going to lead to lower prices? Probably not, because this alone is about the suppliers. The ACCC is actually doing an inquiry into prices at the moment. It's due to hand its report to the government by the end of August. That's hopefully where we see the other side of the coin, where we're looking at what's going to happen with our, with the prices that we're actually paying, as well as hopefully that farmers and suppliers are getting a fair deal as well from the retailers.
Well, Greg, the Greens, they're saying that it's not good enough. They're pushing for powers to forcibly break up that big duopoly. Is that a good idea?
Look, I've always been in favour of having the divestiture powers, but I actually don't think it should be, you know, just focused on the retail sector. When you look at Australia's entire economy, pretty much every industry and every sector, there's less competition than, say, in America, where there are divestiture powers. You know, you think about finance, telecommunications, insurance, energy. You know, we have major providers who are, you know, companies that there's only two or three really to choose from. So I think actually a power to break up is actually good for the entire economy, not just for supermarkets. With supermarkets, a bit trickier because of the supply issues and sort of the bulk need for supplying. But certainly, I think it's a power that all governments should have, and I think the Greens are right on this score that we should bring it in.
Greg, it's good to have you and your distinguished-looking bookshelf on the show. Thank you very much.
No worries, Waleed.